We are continuing third chapter, exercise 3.2, question number 4. I read the question, which of the following are consistent or inconsistent? In case, if it is consistent, then obtain the solution graphically. So there are two sections here. The first section we have to check whether it is consistent or inconsistent. If it is consistent, then we have to obtain the solution graphically. So we have written the second question here, which are not done here, kindly take down for homework. The second sum is x minus y is equal to 8 and 3x minus 3y equal to 16. I have arranged this in the standard form. Starting with x term in the first place, y in the second place, constant in the third place, which is equal to 0. Similarly, the second equation is also expressed in the standard form. This is the first equation, therefore a1, there is no number, therefore it indicates 1. So a1 is equal to 1, b1 is minus 1, and c1 is minus 8. Similarly, a2 is 3, b2 is minus 3, and c2 is minus 16. Now to check whether it is consistent or not, we should find out the ratio of a1 upon a2, which is 1 upon 3. This cannot be simplified. Therefore, I proceed with b1 upon b2, which is minus 1 upon minus 3, which is equal to 1 upon 3. We have to find out the ratio of c1 and c2, which is minus 8 upon minus 16, which is equal to 1 upon 2. So from this we conclude a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2, which is not equal to c1 upon c2. a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2 and not equal to c1 upon c2 from the values we have obtained. When this condition satisfies, we know in the previous video we saw, for such an equation, the given equation becomes inconsistent. Therefore, I write the given pair of equations is inconsistent. Yesterday, we learned the conditions when it becomes consistent and when it becomes inconsistent. Because of this condition, a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2, which is not equal to c1 upon c2. Therefore, we conclude the given pair of equations is inconsistent. Because it is inconsistent, we are not proceeding with the second part of graphical solution. The answer gets over here itself. We proceed to third sum. The equations are written on the board. 2x plus y minus 6 equal to 0 and 4x minus 2y minus 4 equal to 0. It is already given in the standard form. Therefore, directly I have written a1 as 2, b1 as 1 and c1 as minus 6. a2 is 4, b2 is minus 2 and c2 is minus 4. As before, we are going to find out the ratios of a1 upon a2, b1 b2 and c1 c2. So it is 2 upon 4, which is 1 upon 2. b1 upon b2 is 1 upon minus 2 and c1 upon c2 is minus 6 upon minus 4, which is 3 upon 2. Let us observe the answers we have got. Check whether a1 upon a2 is equal to b1 upon b2. Here it is half, whereas here it is minus half. Therefore, we conclude a1 upon a2 is not equal to b1 upon b2. We know in such a situation, the given pair of equation becomes consistent. Therefore, I conclude the answer. The given pair of equations is consistent. When it is consistent, we know we have to do graphical also, so that we are going to proceed. So the given equation is copied here. I found y form. We know what is y form. Just keeping y on the left side and remaining terms to the other side. So it is expressed. 2x, this is shifted to the other side, becomes minus 2x. minus 6 also shifted, it becomes plus 6. So here it is in y form. Therefore, any three random values can be taken for x. So here I have taken three random values for x as 3, 1, 2, and the corresponding values of y are obtained. Y is equal to 0, y is equal to 4, and y is equal to 2. These are listed in the table. This is nothing. Last year also we had done a good number of graphical sums. Now also we had done. These three values can be any you like. Okay, here the table is done. I proceed with the second equation for the same. The given second equation is 4x minus 2y equal to 4. Here I have preferred y form. Therefore, minus 2y is equal to minus 4x plus 4. That is written here. I change sign for all the terms. Therefore, minus 2y becomes plus 2y. Plus 4 becomes minus 4. And minus 4x becomes plus 4x. We have changed opposite sign for each and every term over here. From this I have found y. You can see all the terms are divisible by a common number 2. So dividing, simplifying. Dividing this by 2, we get y. Dividing this by 2, we get minus 2. Similarly, dividing 4x by 2, we get 2x. It is in y form. Therefore, values are assigned for x. Here too, you can take any three values. There is no connection between the second equation and the first equation we have done. So taking any three random values for x as 1, 2, 3, I have got the corresponding values of y and it is tabulated here. So the next work is, the points should be plotted. X is 3, y is 0. X is 3, y is 0, it is plotted. X is 1, y is 4. X is 1, y is 4. We will get this point. The third pair is, x is 2, y is also 2. X is 2, y is also 2. Therefore, I draw a straight line. Please use ruler when you do at home. It should be a straight line, not to draw by hand like me. The board is very smooth, it's difficult to draw, and so use ruler children. The second table is x is 1, y is 0. When the y coordinate is 0, we know the point comes on x axis. So x is 1, y is 0 is this point. The second pair of point is 2, 2. X is 2, y is also 2. So this point is repeated in both the table. Then x is 3, y is 4. So we got 3 points for the second equation. Get a graph, straight line for this. So this is named as 2x plus y minus 6 equal to 0. And this is the second graph we have drawn, which is 4x minus 2y is equal to 4. The question is, if it is consistent, solve graphically. So using the graph, we should identify the value of x and y. How to identify? We should see the point of intersection. These two graphs intersect at this point, so this is the solution. So how to get the values of x and y? Join the point of intersection to x-axis perpendicularly at 90 degree. Use the ruler and join. At which number it meets x-axis, it is 2. That should be written in the first place. Remember, x value should be written in the first place. Then, the same should be joined with y also perpendicularly. Using the ruler, perpendicular. At which number it meets y-axis, 2. Therefore, y value also 2. Need not be same all the time. It can be any number for x or any number for y. So, remember, the point of intersection should be joined perpendicularly to x-axis. At which number it meets, that becomes the value of x. Similarly, join it with y-axis. At which number it meets y-axis becomes the value of y. Therefore, the conclusion is x is equal to y and y is equal to 2. We start with the fifth question. I read the question for you. Half the perimeter of a rectangular garden. So what is the shape here? Rectangular garden. Whose length is 4 meter more than its width. So length is here greater. Greater than what? Greater than the breadth. But how much it is greater? By 4 meter. And its perimeter. given how many meters? 36 meters. The question is find its dimensions. What do you mean by dimensions? It's nothing but length and breadth. So here it is a linear equation in two variables. So let us assume let length of the rectangle be x and breadth of the rectangle be y. We know what is perimeter of rectangle. What is perimeter of rectangle formula? It is 2 into length plus what? Plus breadth. So what is perimeter given? 36. 2. Length we have taken as x and breadth we have taken as y. Therefore, 2 I bring it here. 36 upon 2 is equal to x plus y. Therefore, x plus y is equal to 18 is the first equation. How to frame the second equation? We need a pair of equations to find out the value of x and y. What is the second equation? The second equation is length is 4 meter more than its width. Length is greater than breadth by 4 meters. Length we have assumed as x greater than. Breadth is y. By how many meter it is greater than? By 4. We know the difference is always added with the smaller term. Here x is greater. Therefore, which is smaller? Y is smaller. Therefore, this 4 has to be added with y. Therefore, x is equal to y plus 4 is the second equation. As I explained the previous question, we have to frame table for the first equation. For the second equation, find out where they intersect. The value of x becomes the length of the rectangle and the value of y becomes breadth of the rectangle. So I have written here, complete the graphical part as homework. We go to the last question of the same exercise. The question is, draw the graphs of the equations x minus y plus 1 equal to 0 and 3x plus 2y minus 12 equal to 0. So here the two equations are given. We are asked to draw graphs of the given two equations. After that, determine the coordinates of the vertices of the triangle formed by these lines and the x-axis and shade the triangular region. So here there are three sections. First we should draw the graph and then we should find out the vertices and thirdly we should shade the region. So here this part is very easy, children. This is just a drawing the table. So here I found x form is easier. X form is y minus 1. Y is taken to the right hand side, therefore it becomes plus y. 1 is taken to the right side, it becomes minus 1. So this is the main equation to give values. It is in x form, therefore values are given for y. Any three random values are given and its corresponding x values are formed. Similarly, the second equation, 3x plus 2y minus 12 equal to 0. Forming y form is easier, therefore 2y is equal to, this 12 is taken to the other side, becomes plus 12. 3x is shifted to the other side, therefore it gets its opposite sign, which is minus 3x. Hence, y is 12 minus 3x divided by 2. Then, the three random values I have given for x is 0, 2 and 4. The corresponding values of y we have got are 6, 3 and 0. This calculation hope you will follow very easily. It's very, very simple and it is shown in detail too. Okay. Now we have to plot the points of the first table. So, x is 0, 1. X is 0, the value comes on y axis, therefore this point. Then x is 1, y is 2, we got this point. X is 2, y is 3, we got this point. A straight line is drawn and the equation is written on it as x minus y plus 1 equal to 0. Similarly, in the second table, x is 0, y equal to 6. When the x coordinate is 0, the point lie on y axis. So this is the first point, x equal to 0, y equal to 6. Then x is 2, y is 3. X is 2, y is 3. It's a repeated point in both the tabular column. Then the third point is x is 4, y is 0. So we have drawn both the lines. You can see a triangle is formed. I named the points of intersection as A, B, C. The question is, find out the point of intersection of these two lines and when the lines meet x-axis. You can see the first equation meets x-axis at this point and the second graph, straight line, meets x-axis at this point. The question is, find the vertices of A, B, and what end? C. This is the question. A triangle is formed. What are the three vertices? So I join A with this. At which number it meets x-axis? At 2. I join with this with y, perpendicular, straight line using the ruler. So we got the first coordinate A as 2, 3. Then I come here. We know if any point lie on x-axis, its y coordinate is 0. So at which number it meets x-axis? Minus 1. Because it lies on x-axis, y coordinate becomes 0. Hope you understood, children. It denotes x number, x is minus 1. Because it lies on x-axis, y coordinate becomes 0. Then I come to the point C. At which number it meets x-axis? 4. The 4 I write 4. Because it lies on x-axis, what is the value of y coordinate? 0. Therefore, the coordinates are 2, 3, minus 1, 0, and 4, 0. The question is, shade the triangular region. You can see a triangle ABC is formed. So, let us shade using a ruler neatly